Utility workers from South Florida are back after helping restore power in the Northeast.
They dealt with some interesting challenges as they worked in much different weather than what we're used to here in South Florida.
Kathleen O'Toole has their story, and it's new at 6.
No less than 1,000 FPL workers are back home after grueling 16-hour days restoring power.
The difference was the hurricane this late in the year. Didn't know what to really prepare for.
FPL production lead Jeff Davis is not one for being overly dramatic, but turning the lights, indeed the heat, back on for some was memorable.
It opened our eyes to something different because, you know, not often you get a hurricane then a snowstorm right after. The temperatures dropped pretty cold. And we actually had one lady come up crying to us that she had babies in the house and she had all electrical heat. And what were you doing? It was pretty much quitting time for us, but the guys got in the truck, went over there and helped her out.
This was a very different scenario for Florida power and light crews who are used to heat and humidity for storm cleanup. Sunshine State outerwear proved a bit inadequate.
We weren't all prepared because none of us are prepared to deal with that type of temperature and snow and so on and so forth.
Right, we got a Florida boy who probably was a little chilly.
Very chilly. Did not want to get out of the truck, but had to.
More mature trees made for lots more down power lines than crews typically see in South Florida. And people weren't as prepared for long-term storm mode. But even Davis himself, who made his first trip north of the Mason-Dixon line, learned a thing or two.
Expect the unexpected and carry warm clothes.
So what was the most dangerous part of the trip? Was it being up in the bucket trucks or dealing with potentially energized down power lines? Davis says no, it was getting the hundreds of trucks up and back on I-95 and doing it safely. Reporting in Royal Palm Beach, I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25.